Hi guys, in this tutorial we'll see how to convert a JSON string to a C# object. Here we'll see how to convert a simple nested JSON string into a C# object, then we'll take an example of a complex JSON string, and then we'll see how to use the dynamic type for reading the JSON string. So let's start with the simple nested JSON string. So this is the API which we have used in the previous example. So this API returns a list having a repetitive data structure. So basically it's a list. So now we will see how to convert this JSON string into C# object. So here you can see we have post ID, ID, name, email. So these are the fields which are repetitive. So let's create a class with these attributes. So this is the code from our previous example in which we are calling the get API and we are receiving the JSON string here in this string. So let's create a classes.cs file. Here we will create the class. So let's create a class named as comments which will have all these fields. So I will just create a class named as comments. It will have the name, ID, post ID, email, and the body. So now we'll see how to use this comment class for converting this JSON string into a C# object. So we'll just write var serializer equal to new JavaScript serializer. So it is from the class system.web.script.serialization. So now we'll use the serializer variable dot deserialize, and here we'll pass the JSON string which we have to convert to a C# object. So in this case it is string result test. And a target type, that is the type in which we have to convert it. So as you can see, since this JSON is of type list, so we'll define a list object of that class which we have just created. So in target we'll just write type of and list comments. Now since this string will be converted into a type of list of comments class, we'll assign it to a object of type list comments. So we'll just write list of comments object list equal to that particular object. Now since this is throwing error because we have to typecast it with type of list, so we'll just write list comments. And that's it. And here we are just using the deserialize method of the serializer in which we are just passing the JSON string and the type to which we have to convert. That is, we are converting it into a C# object of type list of the comments class which we have just created. We are assigning it to an object of type list of comments. Now since it's a list, we can easily loop through this list. We can use for each comments obj in op list, and we'll just use this string name equal to object dot name. Similarly, we can take string email equal to obj.email. And post ID. So let's run this application. Okay, so this is our previous code. We have our API call here with the GET request. And you can see we have our JSON string here. It is a list and having record of same type. So let's press F5. Now we'll just initialize our serializer, JavaScript serializer. After that, we'll use the deserialize method for converting this string to our C# object of type list of comments. Okay, so now you can see we have 5 records here, and we will just use the for each loop for looping through this list. So you can see the first record, email, ID is 1, second record, that is 2. The third record, ID 3. And that's it. So thus, this was an example of converting a simple JSON string into a C# object. So now we'll take an example of a complex JSON string whose data structure is not repetitive. So this is the example of a complex JSON string. So you can see here, there are 2 root elements. One is the data and the other one is the other data. So let's see the first root element, data. Inside data, there is an element type of data 1, which itself is a list having fields ID and name, and there are 2 records. Second, there is a second element type of data 2, which is also having fields ID and company, but this is not of type list. And the last is the other data element, the root element, which is having only one attribute, thing. So let's see how we can read this complex data structure into our C# object. So I'll keep the thing very simple. We'll start with other data, the second root element. We'll create a class named as other data, which is having one field named as thing. So let's go to classes.cs. So we'll just create a class named as other data, and we'll just have one field, thing. So we are done with the other data root element. So we'll just start with our inner elements. So now we'll create the class for type of data 2, which is having ID and company field. So I will just create a class type of data 2, and I will just keep 2 fields, ID and company. So we are trying to replicate the JSON structure with the help of classes. So we'll see it further. So we are done with type of data 2. So now we'll begin with a class named as type of data 1, which is nothing but a list having a records of type ID and name fields. So now we'll create a class type of data 1, which will have 2 fields, ID and name. Okay, so finally we are done with all the inner classes, type of data 2, type of data 1. So now we'll move to our main root element, first root element, data. And we'll try to incorporate all these in this data structure. So let's see how. So let's create our first root element, that is data. Now you can see inside data, there is a list of type of data 1. So we already have a class of this type of data 1. So what we'll do, we'll just write public ilist type of data 1 of type list. So this is nothing but this class, type of data 1, ID and name. Second, we have the second element, type of data 2, which is not a list, it is having only one record, having field ID and company. So we have already created this class also, type of data 2. There is this. So I'll use this class also. But this time it is not of type list. It is simply public type of data 2. So now we will create our main outermost object, which will have both these elements, the root elements, that is data and other data and all this type. So I will just create the main class, public class complex JSON, which is having both the root elements, the data this one and the other data this one. So in the similar fashion we'll use this also, we'll just define serializer dot deserialize. Our JSON, we'll just define a string which will have this JSON, complex JSON structure. Now this is nothing but the same JSON which we have used here. So we'll just write, we'll just pass the JSON string and the type which we have to convert into, that is the complex JSON which we have just created here. We'll assign it to a object of type complex JSON and we'll typecast it to complex JSON. Now let's see how we can read all the elements of this JSON. So let's begin with data. We'll just read the type of data 1 list. We can use for each loop. Here we are just writing type of data 1 in object 1. Dot data dot type of data 1. So you can see here this complex list have data and in this data we have type of data 1 which is nothing but list. So we can just read it as id equal to list dot id. Similarly, string name equal to list dot name. Now we can easily loop through this list. Second thing we want is type of data to, which is not a list. We can directly access this ID and company fields. So let's see how we can directly write response.write object list one dot data dot type of data to dot ID. Similarly, we will write object list one dot data dot type of data to dot company. You can directly access this. Now comes the last element, that is the other data root element, which is having only one attribute thing. So here also we'll simply write object list dot other data dot and the thing. So let's run this now. Okay, we have a debugger here. So this is the JSON. Our complex JSON. And here we are going to use the deserialize method for converting the JSON into our complex JSON object. So here we are reading the type of data one element, which is nothing but this. So we are looping through type of data one, and you can see the ID is one and the name is Johnny. Again, the ID is 2 and the name is Harry. So we have read this list, ID name. So now we'll see type of data to having ID and company. So here directly we are going here and we are reading this ID. And you can see it is 4, which is here, and the company name, which is XYZ. You can see it here, the company name. XYZ. So now comes our last element, other data, which is having a field thing. So we can directly access it. Object one dot other data dot thing, which is something. The value is something. So in this way, we can easily read a complex JSON string into a C# object. So now we'll see the use of dynamic type. So in this previous example, you can see that we have deserialized the JSON string and converted into a hardcore type of list of comments. So what if I don't want to create a class name as comments and still I have to read this JSON string? So here the dynamic type comes into picture, because there is no compulsion to convert the JSON string into a particular hardcore type of class. We can use a runtime object. So let's see how. So in the previous example, we'll just write dynamic data test equal to the serializer which we have used here, JavaScript serializer, dot deserialize will give the string, comma, and the type. So you just write type of an object. So here we are not binding it to a type of a hardcode class. Here we are just binding it to a type of object which will be defined at runtime. So I will just write where data JSON string equal to data test. So since this first API, the first example, was returning us a list of repetitive records, we will just assign this to an object of type array. So here we will just write object array, and we will just assign our data test dynamic object. So now we will use this for loop. Since this is not a C# object, it's a manual process for looping through this object array. So here I will just write ID from this data JSON string which is here, and the name field. From this particular index. So we are looping through this object data JSON string array. So let's see how this dynamic type helps us to loop through the JSON string without converting it into a hardcode C# class. So I have just taken the ID and name field here. I am not printing the other fields. So let's run this. So we have called the API. This is the result. And now we are going to use our dynamic type for deserializing this to a object of type object. So you can see here we have 5 records. So now we can loop through this. ID is 1, name is this. The second record, ID 2, name. Third record, ID 3, and the name. 4, name. And the last record, 5, and the name. That's it. So thus we have seen how to convert a simple JSON string to a C# object. We have seen an example of a complex data structure, and we have also seen the use of dynamic type for reading the JSON string. So that's it, guys. Thanks for watching. Kindly subscribe, like, or share.